shall come into our land.
When somebody come at you, in our land, come aggravate you, Jesus is your peace. You able to stand in Jesus. Okay.
And when he shall tread in our palaces.
When they try to come into our dominion, thread in our dominion, he's right there. He's in the middle. You think about when Moses and them was crossing the Red Sea, and here come Pharaoh and them. And what God did, he let them got right in them.
Yeah.
And he drowned them out. Sometimes things would come in a place, he'll let them get right in the middle of your stuff. Mm-hmm. And then he'll come in and drown them out. Don't mean they gonna destroy you. I'm just getting them in the middle so you can see what I can do.
Amen.
Amen. Just stand. Oh my God. Thank you, Jesus.
Then shall we raise against him 7 shepherds and 8 principal men.
You gonna what?
Raise
them up. He's gonna raise them up. You can't raise yourself. He's going to raise you up.
Amen.
And that's why I thank God for the raising
up.
He's raising you up.
Amen.
He know how to raise you. Mm-hmm. Thank God for him raising you up. Mm-hmm. To make you king, priest, or high call.
Amen.
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 Thank you, Jesus. I got one more. Let's go to Ephesians 5. We're going to read 16 to 24. Mm-hmm. Start at verse 16. 16 to 24.
See then that ye walk circumspectly, not as fools, but as wise.
So you can't be walking as what? Jesus wasn't no
fool.
So you can't walk as a fool. See then that you. Okay.
Redeeming the time.
So he's what? Redeeming the time. He redeeming the time.
Because the days are evil.
He redeeming the time because the days are evil. So you ain't got time to play around with foolish stuff.
Amen.
He redeeming the time. Evil is not going to keep lurking the earth. Jesus is going to come back and he's going to war against the wicked.
Amen.
So you ain't got time to be playing these foolish.
Amen.
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 All right, come on.
Wherefore, be ye not unwise, but understanding what the will of the Lord is.
So don't be what? He telling us don't be unwise, but understand. What is the will the Lord is? So I need to see what God think, what Jesus think, not what man think, what the Lord thinks. Amen. Luke, now tell me what you're thinking, Lord.
And be not drunk with wine.
To be not drunk with wine.
Wearing in excess.
Yes,
but be filled with the Spirit.
He telling you don't be so drunk with the world, but be filled with the Spirit. Be more concerned about spiritual things than you do worldly things.
Amen.
I was looking on the news today. They finna they got the computer now where you don't have to do the thing. You do your hand. Mm-hmm. Many people gonna get caught up in these things of the world. He said, don't get caught up in these things.
Mm-hmm.
Don't be so drunk.
Amen.
With these things.
Mm-hmm.
Glory to the world. Glory to God. Come on. The world.
Speaking to yourselves in psalms and hymns and spiritual songs, singing and making melody in your heart to the Lord.
So I need to do what? To keep myself encouraged and lifted up, I need to do these things. Yeah. Speak to yourself. In songs and hymns and spiritual songs, sing and make melody in your heart to the Lord. Come.
Yeah, you sure?
encouraging you. Amen. Thank you, Jesus. All right, come on, Nick.
Giving thanks always for all things unto God and the Father in the name of our Lord Jesus Christ.
So I need to keep what? Thanking Him. Thank you, Lord. No matter what my day came out, Lord, thank you. Ooh, thank you, I made it.
Yes, Lord. Jesus. Yes, Lord. Thank you.
See, just thanking Him.
Yes, thank you, Lord.
Ooh, my God, we get mad, but thank you.
Yes, Lord, thank you.
Ooh, glory to God. I love you especially, Lord.
Thank you. Amen.
Thank you.
Amen.
You know, and sometimes we be going through things, and we think we can't bear it, but He said He won't put no more on us than we can bear.
Right.
And in our temptations, He always make a way of escape if we stay in tune with Him and to the Spirit.
Right.
And then later on that evening, you'd be going, wow.
You don't even thank
you. Lord, you and you only brought me through this.
That's it. Amen. That's why He says, speak to yourself in song and hymn. Thank you, Jesus. Think of a song. Sometimes our song just come to me. And I just said, Lord, and sometimes scriptures come to me. Help me to keep me going.
Amen.
Amen. I said, Lord, nobody doing this but you.
Amen.
You don't want to know me.
Thank you.
Amen.
Amen.
All right, verse 20.
Giving thanks always for all things unto God and the Father in the name of our Lord Jesus Christ.
Just constantly giving Him thanks. Just keep thanking. I don't care what it looks like, because God got a way of you escaping out of anything through your thanksgiving.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. When anything He got you trapped or bad in,
yes,
God bring you to the good.
Yes,
so God will put you through something that you can't bear. He don't, and He's not a God of evil.
Amen.
He's a God of good. He will bring you out. Amen. Your way said.
Submitting yourselves one to another in the fear of God.
So we need to submit yourself one to another in the fear of God. It's not. I think about it a lot, but I ain't giving them nothing. You are more braver than the person that you are thinking that they think you're scared.
Mm-hmm.
All you did is submit. Mm-hmm. You submitted to the Lord. You bring honor to the Lord. Mm-hmm. You can stop a lot of stuff by submitting your ways.
Mm-hmm.
And then I submit, you're not being scared of nobody. Mm-hmm. You just submit to one another and unto the Lord. If I, two people are, if I argue, you argue, so we both end up doing something we regret.
Mm-hmm.
But if I submit and not bicker back with you, you gonna soon quit arguing.
That's right.
See, but you keep arguing, I'm arguing, all we do is hiding in the flesh.
That's right.
And then we end up hurting each other.
Right.
Amen.
Amen.
So we learn to what? Submit. Especially when you know you're dealing with a fool, dog. With a fool.
Mm-hmm.
Amen. Watch your person. You just about know how to, what to deal with them with.
Mm-hmm.
I got something around me all the time. Fool.
High five.
I know I'm dealing with a fool.
Mm-hmm.
So I don't fool with a fool.
Right.
Amen. Right. Amen. I had to get on down there with the wife part to get to 24.
Wives, submit yourselves unto your own husbands, as unto the Lord.
See what it said, as unto the Lord. Everything you're doing, you submit it unto the Lord. Amen. I don't want to talk about wives and husbands. I just want to get down to 24.
Well, the husband is the head of the wife.
Okay, the husband is the head of the wife.
Even as Christ is the head of the church.
Even Christ is the head of the church. So Christ is your husband, man.
Amen.
So you have to what? Submit unto Christ.
Amen.
Submit to Jesus.
Amen.
You submit your will. Amen. To Jesus. You give your will up to Jesus.
Amen.
So you live in Jesus' will.
Amen.
I put like will and testimony.
Amen.
Amen. All right, come on.
And He is the Savior of the body.
Now who is your Savior?
Jesus.
So you can withstand in Jesus.
Amen.
My God. Thank you, Jesus. All right, verse 24, this is my last one.
Therefore, as the church is subject unto Christ.
So we got to be who? Subject to who?
To Christ.
To Christ. We got to. If you going to survive and have what you want, you got to bring it under suggestion to him. Mm-hmm. Amen. Mm-hmm. He got to be in the middle of it. Hallelujah. Anything you do, put him in. I don't care if you say, I desire a pair of shoes. Pray about it.
Amen.
Just don't go buy them shoes.
Hallelujah.
Be honest. Because if you do that, where you might be trying to buy, you love the shoe, he can pull them on sale and you get them less than what the price was.
Amen.
Come on, you. And he said, give it to me.
Amen.
I don't care what it is. Lord, I tell you one person do that, we'll do it. Bland called me every day. Bland do not buy nothing. She wouldn't even buy a blouse without you. Apostle. Pray with me. She don't do nothing till she pray. She don't even give nothing to nobody till she pray over. That's one thing I can say about her. That woman do that. And God just keep blessing
me. I know one preacher I listened to, he says that would stop you from having to take stuff back too if you had to pray about it. You would have knew it wouldn't fit or wasting time taking stuff back.
Yeah. I don't care what it is, the children, even your husband, whatever, pray. Your job, put him in the middle.
Amen.
Amen. If you put him in the middle, he gonna straighten that thing. And I'm telling you, she do that.
Yes,
she pray. I mean, pause, I hate to bother you, but you have a moment to pray with me?
Mm-hmm.
She pray about everything. That woman don't buy nothing till she pray to God about it. I don't care what it is. What should I do? She can't get hold of them folks. They won't call her back from the Social Security play. And she said, well, she already started writing the letter. She called me. I wrote this letter for why you prayed about it. Now let us pray. And then we pray. And that's what the Lord led her to write that letter. When they won't call her, he said, now get me in there, my word.
I was going to say, some people too, I've told somebody that and they really didn't honor me saying, well, I need to pray about it first.
Mm-hmm.
They, no, you don't. Yes, mm-hmm. Yes, I do.
Don't move. Don't do nothing till you pray about it. And when you pray on, God bless you.
Pray.
It's a scripture saying all your ways.
Acknowledge.
Yeah.
He'll
direct your path.
Direct your path. See, that's how you can, your life be much more smooth.
Yeah.
You got some answers? Oh, I thought you had, I saw your hand did like that.
Well, I think that's true what you said, because this morning, or last night, I can't remember, I was praying or talking to God, and I was telling him what I wanted to do today, and I said that I wanted to finish up the school shopping for my daughter, and I said, but I don't know where to go, and I was like, maybe you can, you know, just talking to him about it, asking him, and then I went to J.C. Penney's, and I did get some good stuff. It came right up to $100, and I got a lot, though. So I felt like I, because I prayed, then I was wise about how I spent it, and I got a good deal on the stuff that I got, and I got a lot, I think.
Amen. That's what I'm saying. You give it to him. A lot of people thinking, oh, you got to pray about everything. Yes, pray about it. Put God in, he would direct your path just where you need to go. And you won't be spending a whole lot of money or whatever. Amen. He might say, just wait. Don't get it now. I got a plan for it. I'll get to you. Amen. Amen. He got your stuff. My God, I thank you. Hallelujah. Just pray.
Something to say, too, it's kind of off the topic of, it's on the topic, but kind of off. But the reason I'm saying is because the power of prayer, when I say that, is you pray on something every day, and I pray and I ask God for the armor of God over me and over my children.
Mm-hmm.
And today, when I was at work and I came home, my kids told me that a white man from, they had Johnson County tags, came up and asked them, do they buy ice cream? And then asked them to get $5 and try to lure them to the car. Well, he was at this one particular boy. And the neighbor, she told my mother that she was tired. She had not felt good at work today. She went in the house and she said she was going to lay down. But something just told her to go back outside. So I just want to say thank you, Lord, for always watching over my children, even when I don't have them in my sight. And I just want to say thank you for that, because I just wanted to say that because it's just the power of prayer. Like, I've been praying for that. And it's like the arm of God is over everything. Mm-hmm. And he shielded my children today and other children in the neighborhood. So I just want to give the Lord praise and say thank you.
Amen. 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 See, he knows what's in the lurking. In any area, if we put him before it. Amen. I thank God. Amen. I praise God for that, because so much is going on. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. That's a testimony by itself. Amen.
So let the wives be to their own husbands in everything.
In everything.
Amen.
Amen. Therefore, okay, verse 24. Tell it again. I'm 24.
Therefore, as the church is subject unto Christ, so let the wives be to their own husbands in everything.
So what it's saying is the basis, the church, on where Jesus was suggested to, he was submitted to everything that would bring the body of the church that the Father had created. Mm-hmm. He was submissive to it. Mm-hmm. He died so the church could what? Live. Yeah. Amen. So we are the church.
Amen.
Amen. So it's like he's saying, base your marriage on the church. The way he was. Amen. And that's why sometimes we as believers and we as women, we need to be more submissive to the Spirit of God so we won't step out of time with our companion marriage. God haven't put it all in order. He gave me a revelation with that today too, about marriage. Mm-hmm. God gave it to me like, there's nothing wrong with the marriage. Mm-hmm. Marriage at all. What happened is why is so many people marriage and divorces is they married but they didn't change their mindset. Mm-hmm. Their mindset still single. And they married, but they think single. Mm-hmm. But when you marry, you're not single no more. You're married, you're more. But they still think single. And that's what happened to a lot of marriages. Because they stay single-minded. Then you're not single-minded, you're married. So you're no more one, you are two of y'all. He gave to me today. So Lord, thank you. Too many single-minded people married. You can't be married to a man or woman and you try to go party all night.
No.
That's single. Single-minded. Amen. Thank God.
Amen.
So then you got that age.
Yes, ma'am.
Get it all out your nail. Get all your single days out. Father, we thank you right now by the blessing of the Lord. Make it rich in the end, no sorrow. Lord God, we understand that we got to withstand. And all to do is to stand. And Lord God, we thank you tonight that we learned it, that we praise you and give you glory and keep you in the midst of everything that we do. God, that you would enable us to withstand in these days. And Lord God, we give you glory and praise for you being our standard, that we can live and have our beings in you. And Lord God, we give you praise and glory. We ask you now to bless the offering as you see fit for the keeping of your kingdom, that you increase it like never before. And I thank you for 104 of the finances coming forward now. In Jesus' name. Amen. Amen. Thank the Lord. Amen. Come on, let's give God a hand. Ladies, we gonna stand. Done all to do. Stand. We can't do no more. Just stand, okay? Don't be moved by what you see or hear. Just stand. Amen. Because when you don't stand, you do foolish things. Amen. Amen. Well, I thank God for tonight. Sunday morning, we'll be right back in this place. Amen. To give God the praise.